Is called I Believe in Fairies, and my inspiration comes from fairy tales. I like to write stories and poetry, and I like to illustrate what I write. And I got a friend to model for me, so it's a portrait of her. Basically, I've been working on a theme of fruits and fantasy. So local fruits, this is passion fruit, and hummingbirds. So it's a theme I've been working on. The one over there is golden apple and frogs and toads, frog fairies, frogs with wings. I was studying overseas and at the School of Visual Arts in New York, and I just came back, so I haven't been seeing anyone's work for like the last 4 years. So I'm very excited to see everyone's work tonight, because a lot of people I went to the community college with, and I think the work looks great. Everything looks beautiful.
When it comes to inspiration, my work, it happens every day, and it's not usually the same thing. It kind of just happens, and when I decide to paint something, I just paint it. Because I'm more into graphic design, so when I get to paint, it's more so when I have a thought, I just paint it quickly and get it done and get back to work. Like, I'm feeling it a lot more than graphic design. Graphic design is cool, but I find it a little sterile, a little here today, gone tomorrow. Where fine art is just fine art, you know? And these pieces kind of stood out. I do work from my head sometimes they're images that just catch you off guard, you know? And I saw this image and I thought the dog was kind of cool, but it wasn't just a dog. He looked a little smarter than a dog, so I just want to put a tie on him, you know, make him a little snazzier. And this one was just another quick sketch. And the whole exhibition is about illustration and diversity, so I wanted to try a couple different styles. And you're getting a lot more younger art students, friends of art students coming out to exhibitions, and it's really good. You see most of the time a different crowd, and a lot of people think that you can't come to art exhibitions because that's not the crowd for you, or you can't adapt, or you can't be in that sort of social scene. But that's garbage. Like, you should just come to see art, because art is for everyone. And yeah, man, that's pretty much it. Like, this is a good exhibition so far.
My inspiration for most of my work is usually just a love of art and photography and just illustration on a whole. So most of my pieces, this one in particular was done really and truly from a photograph that I took and merged it kind of with a photograph that I saw of this beautiful little girl that was kind of almost like a little boy, and everyone thinks it was this little boy, but it was like staring off into the distance. And I just love the essence of the photograph that I decided to paint it and try to capture that essence in a more minimal kind of form with texture and whatnot. So that's kind of thing. But most of my work is usually about what you're going to see here in illustration is just pure illustration. Come up with a concept, idea, and then execution. Simbah Pilé, who really is the host of the whole exhibition and got a group of us artists together to do this. It was always her idea to kind of really show the depth of illustration and it not just being one type of strict genre, because there's fine art illustration, there's animation, there's Japanimation, all that comes into illustration.
Well, I submitted 3 art pieces, which the 2 behind me, one is Splash, this one over here, and the other one behind me is Rapid Light. The one down below is a blueprint, which name, changing room. So what it is, I can't remember, what it is, the one with the dolls, that came from an animation called Boom Boom Beep Beep, because everyone know me from my animations, like Boom Boom Beep Beep or Town. But I want to show people that I'm not known for animation, but I also do like drawings and mixed media. So what I did is, I did like a storyboard and mixed media, and also make it into a comic strip. So I took random balloons from a comic strip, like for instance Garfield Peanuts, and put it into the comic. So what happened is in this scene, I took a floor plan of a car and then it's driving and it splashed the dog. But don't take it too literal. It just come from, it's a storyboard of an animation. And it just took a random balloon that said, tell her to try not to realize that life is full of disappointment. Now, I don't know what that means, but it could mean something to somebody else because you could interpret it in many different ways. You could laugh, you could maybe take it serious, or you could get offended. And the one behind me, it's like more panel comic. And there's the dog again, and it says, sometimes I think it just never get to use to going barefoot. Again, I don't know what that means, but it could be funny, and it's just like a comic strip mixed media slash storyboard of the animation, boom, boom, beat. So I think the exhibition is fantastic. I really enjoy being in the show and also being with other artists, and their work are so different, but yeah, it come together because it have a similar style of illustration, and I think Simbah did a fantastic job picking out the 7 artists.
My name is Aurelia Wallcot. I'm a visual artist. Usually I specialize in printmaking, but for this specific exhibition, my work has primarily focused in painting. And what I'm doing is painting acrylic on paper. In these series, I'm working on images that were taken underwater. In each of these pictures, they're all using my friends, all of them are artists. And it's just from a fun day at the beach where we were frolicking, we were doing everything under the water, everything was great. And what I have done in each image is I've taken the photograph, I've made a photocopy, and I've done what you call as a transfer. And in that, I'm using acrylic gel medium to transfer the photocopy to the paper, and then I paint on top of that. In each of the pieces, it's a whimsical piece. It doesn't have an in-depth meaning, but it's supposed to bring out the fun and the joy of everyday life and things that we usually miss because of work and because of other commitments that we usually have. So this comes after a piece called Water Roots, and that again was taken in the beach. It comes from using the hair, and this is continuing the series, and this is the end of the Water Roots series.
Basically, this piece is an excerpt from a graphic novel that I was working on called Heartman. The novel itself is actually completed, the artwork, and right now it's going through the editing phase. But every now and again, I would exhibit some excerpts from the piece. And this is actually from chapter 5. The whole story is based on a local folktale, and I kept the artwork. The time that I started this, I was very much into the aesthetic of black and white photography, also some subtle influences from manga, but of course my style is very much unlike manga. I try to keep in my own identity. The other two pieces behind me, though, these are some more recent work. This is all 100% digital ink with Wacom tablet and colored with the same Wacom in Photoshop. One was just actually a study for a character that was created by a guy named Alan Lynch. And there's just a study trying to capture the attitude and look at the character, and it piece kind of works on its own. The lower piece too is a spread from another comic written by Alan again. This time this is hand inked and colored digitally. This comic is from issue 4 of Mass Anthology, which hasn't been released yet. Actually, a lot of this work this is the first time the public will really be seeing some of this work. Some of it is kind of old to me, but due to the public, probably like 2 years. This one's probably like 2 years. These are new, just a few months.
Well, normally I work with narratives, which are like fairy tales and stuff of that nature. However, I like to use text in my work, and these aren't based off any specific fairy tales, but the idea was to utilize the text to tie the work together. Now, the pieces, they are not necessarily related beyond the text, and they all have like different inspirations. In Pouring Riddles with No Answer, I made this piece as a collage, and it's a mixture of a photographic image, which has been drawn on top of with ink, and a separate ink drawing, which is done on like the paper behind, which is the photograph has been pasted on top of. And I utilized ink and transfer, which is a special printmaking method where you use chemicals and it pushes the ink off of one surface into another. The inspiration of this piece was Alice in Wonderland, in a kind of sense, with the idea of, like, you know, that you have a magic potion, it either makes you big or small, but with this one here, it's more like the magic potion is undetermined and it's more with an idea. This is why there's text utilized in this work. Walking on Words is a collage, which is done with the same printmaking technique, which utilizes chemicals and pushes the ink into another surface, as well as chincolate, which is a type of gluing method, where you glue paper on a different surface. It's usually a printmaking technique as well. Well, the exhibition itself, the idea started with the fact that I think illustration is underdeveloped in Barbados, and it's not usually utilized as a career option. Personally, I want to be an illustrator, and I know a number of other people that are interested in that genre. I was very interested in getting a group of artists together that, this well, made figurative pieces that fit the what I consider illustration, which is like a very broad spectrum. So how I got this together was that I discussed with a gallery, the person who runs the gallery, her name is Therese Hattie, and I expressed to her that I was interested in having a group show, and I wanted to do illustration, which is my personal interest, and I was going to contact the artist that I thought would suit the exhibition, which is why I did via Facebook. We're going to have another event, which is going to be like a more casual event where there will be kind of like you can talk with the artists about their work, and we're going to have like a barrel of lime, in the sense of actual lime.